Hello, welcome back to my channel. In previous video, I have introduced an Excel macro on generating a non-scheduled report and month payment period level. As my Excel example file shows, the 20 years non-scheduled report with loan amount 200k euros and 3.8% interest. It has 240 monthly repayment periods. From the VBA macro generated report, we can easily find how much we pay in each period for the interest and principal, and get the idea on the trend of the two portions during the loan payment period. Maybe users want to have a glance view on how much we pay for the two portions and the yearly level. For such leads, we may need to create another macro to generate a yearly non-scheduled report based on aggregated monthly repayments. For example, in my Excel file, I have the macro to get what users wanted based on the same loan input, 20 years non-scheduled report. By running the macro from the generated report, we can get the same kind of detail info and the aggregated yearly level. In this video, I shall share a way to create such VBA macro based on modifying my previous created VBA macro, which generates monthly non-scheduled report. In the screen, we have two VBA project windows vertically. In the left project window, we have the previous created VBA procedure for month-long schedule report. And in the right project window, we have the just created VBA procedure for year-long schedule report. According to left-hand side codes, the first part is define required variables. For right-hand side, we keep all defined variables except for month name variable M name, as we only report payment and yearly period. Here we need to add two additional variables, yearly interest and yearly principal for year-long schedule report. Replace the variable name which starts with period by monthly for distinguish the monthly payment with yearly payment. In the second part, set known input sheet and load known details from it. Here nothing changing, but just keep all for right-hand side as we need the same known input. The third part is calculate the fixed period payment. In the right-hand project window, we need to calculate fixed yearly payment based on calculated fixed monthly payment. Thus, just an additional code line to use calculated monthly payments times 12 to get the fixed yearly payment. The fourth part, clear report sheet and add new report headers. In right-hand project window, we removed the column header month name and replaced the column header month name payment by yearly payment. As we have removed the month name column, thus we need to adjust the column index number as well. We have major changes in fifth part, calculate payment details for each year period. In right-hand project window, to the initial value settings for value holders, we still need to initialize the remaining balance value as previous procedure, but not need to do the setting for month variable and also not need to convert long term from year level to month level. Additionally, we need to set zero initial values for period interest as it will be value holder and accumulate the calculated monthly interest in the listed monthly iteration loop under year iteration loop. Compared with the left-hand monthly non-report VBA procedure, the right-hand VBA procedure will require two iteration loops. The higher level iteration is yearly iteration loop within long term by year number I, and the lower level iteration is month iteration loop within a year 12 months by month number month. Firstly, within the month iteration loop, the major targets are to calculate monthly interest for accumulating the yearly interest for year I, and calculate monthly principal for concluding remaining balance for year I. After this 12-month iteration round for year I, we have the yearly interest and the remaining balance for year I. With these two results, we can update yearly principal for year I by deducting year payment with the yearly interest, and updated the year starting balance for next year I plus 1. Same as the left-hand VBA procedure, before step into next year I loop or quit long-term yearly loop, we need to load all calculated results into report sheet and reset the zero value for yearly interest holder and update year number holder if year I loop still not reach the end of long term yet. The last part is to format report sheet and display completion message, almost the same as the left procedure, and just a minor adjustment on the numbers of column index for formatting. Okay, the new procedure for generating aggregated year non-schedule report is ready for testing. Let's place a new non-term number, 10 years. Then run the new macro in right-hand window. Then we see the expected result. Do not forget to add a macro button in main pager and assign the new macro to the button. The detailed steps on how to add macro button can be referred to my previous video. That is all about this video. I have attached the URL link of the VBA codes in this video descriptions. Hope it brings some help for your projects. Thanks for watching, and if you like to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscriber button. See you in next video.